Let's face it, you want a pet T-Rex just as much as I do. But is that even possible? I mean, surely it must be impossible to bring back an animal that's been extinct for 66 million years. Or is it? In Jurassic Park, the dinosaurs were brought back to life by cloning them with DNA found in fossilized amber. While the cloning bit isn't that far off, DNA just doesn't last that long. You see, DNA has a half-life of 521 years. What this means is that in 521 years, only 50% of the DNA is left. 521 more years, only a quarter of it. And so on and so forth. So by the time you reach 66 million years, the DNA is basically completely gone. Okay, so we won't get a baby T-Rex anytime soon. But what about a woolly mammoth? The majority of woolly mammoths died out only 10,000 years ago. While this is a lot closer than 66 million years, it still means that by the time scientists today would find the DNA, there would be less than 0.001% of the DNA left. But what about something a little more recent? What about a dodo bird? The last confirmed sighting of a dodo bird was in 1662. That's a lot closer to now than 10,000 years ago. That was only 355 years ago at the time of this video, which means that there is still over 50% of the DNA of a dodo bird out there somewhere. If we found enough of it from multiple different sources, we could theoretically get a complete genome of a dodo bird. But then what? Well, then you clone it. But how? Basically, you take the DNA of the dodo bird and put it inside the egg of the closest living relative, which is the Nicobar pigeon. Then you wait and hope. And when it hatches, hopefully you'll have a baby dodo bird. While we may not get to see a baby stegosaurus anytime soon, I sure wouldn't mind having a pet dodo bird. I personally would name mine Bori. What would you name yours? Leave it in the comments down below. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you liked it, why not watch some of my other videos, and subscribe if you really liked it. Thanks for watching, and have a fabulous day.